Hello, I want to present my novel methods with two neural nets. I am from Russia, from Novosibirsk city. The short description is follow. First we resize net to the small scale, and first net detects centers of each glomerulus. Then we make a crop around each glomerulus, and second net predict radii of edge on the edge. Here is the details. So the resized image goes to the neural net, and the output is an image. Here is an example of output. It is image with dots, and after that special algorithms apply a threshold and detect the center of this glomerulus. Also, the value of the spot is normalized to 1 and can be used as probability of detection. For example, this empty glomerulus has low probability. Receptive field of the net is big enough to have a good detection. Also, only this net can be used, for example, to count number of glomerulus. Next stage is on the big scale. We have a crop image around center, and it makes an unrolled. Here is unrolled image, and green dots is predicted radii. After that, we can draw a shape of the glomerulus. Here is unrolled explained. First, we have crop. And then we started to unroll it. So now we make a rectangle image. Of course, it's just for animation. In real code, it's just make a remap function. It's very fast. Also, I tried another alternative net for big scale that predicts edges with image, and then it used watershed algorithm. Also, I made a lot of visualization for contour image, for combined big and small scale, and for big scale. Also, I used dice metrics separately for small scale with this value, for big scale with this value, and combine it was this value. I didn't use folding, so the private test dataset matrix is more reliable and had this value. Also, I made separate matrix for each image for small scale, and found that some images that are spoiled has low dice matrix. Here is the optimization of the threshold for small scale. I found some insight that spoiled images had bad annotation because it's difficult to annotate in spoiled images, and the solution is to annotate only good images and then spoil them with augmentation. Also, spoiled images give low dice metric, and the solution is to increase train dataset. The method can be used to detect other objects if the objects are convex enough and don't have strong overlap. Also, the best way to use the method is to detect all glomerulus, including sclerosed glomerulus and empty glomerulus, because it's more simple for the net. And then use another separate net that can detect if it's sclerosed or if it's empty. That's all. Thank you.